This is a build video for the core structure of the brig from the Pirate Ship series. The tools I will be using are a ruler for helping me cut, an X-Acto knife with a sharp blade, and an empty ball pen. A cutting knife can do harm, so be careful using it and put the cover back on when not using it. If you're a minor, be sure to get help and assistance from a grown-up. I use rubber cement glue, which doesn't dry too fast, so I have time to move and adjust parts when gluing them together. Before our cutout parts, I score the folding edges. For that I use the empty ball pen, drawing kind of invisible lines over the edges. The pressure will make a dent in the paper, which allows me to make the folds. It doesn't cut the paper like it would if you used the knife for scoring, and so leaving structural integrity intact. Next, I cut out the parts, usually with the help of a ruler. This helps me to keep my cutting lines straight. If you feel comfortable, you can also free cut lines. Once cut out, I pre-fold along all the edges, so I know later which way to go. I'll continue to cut out all remaining parts before the next step. Once you cut out all the parts, make sure to understand how they go together. For the core, there are two layers. Parts with uppercase letters for one layer, and those with lowercase letters for the other. I copied the letters to the inside of the parts for better readability. There's the option to build with closed or no gun ports, like here. Or with open gun ports, as shown here. On some parts, you will see these gray squares marking the spaces where the gun ports will go. If you want the open version, you need to cut them out along the outer edge of the grey lines. Again, make sure you cut out along the outer grey line. Obviously, if you want the closed gun ports option, ignore this step. Here you can see all the lowercase core parts with gun ports cut out. To make sure no white edges will peek through the textured parts, we need to color some edges. I use some scrap paper to help with the coloring so I don't color the cutting mat. I suggest you use black or neutral gray for this step. color along the lines where the textured planking parts would meet. Along the upper edge and around the gunport openings. Also, repeat this process on the inside for the upper edge and gunport openings. I'll complete this for the rest now. Here are all the lowercase layer parts edge colored. Make sure to color the inside corner edge of the stern part as shown here. Now we can start to glue parts together. I start with the front or bow section. I first apply some glue. And then distribute it equally with my finger. I brush off excess glue on my finger either on a scrap piece of paper or like here on the other part to be glued. I make sure to position the part right by folding up the outward tabs centering the glued part. I then use the ruler's edge to distribute the glue even better and pressing the parts together. Turning over the assembly, I glue the extending bit to the next part using the same methods. The stern or back section goes together in a similar fashion. Finally, it's time to glue both sections together. I like to let flat sections like this dry by putting them between two cardboard pieces and then putting a couple of heavy books onto that. Before we continue with the next step of adding the textured parts, I glue the tabs in the stern section of the core to form the proper shape. That concludes building the core of the brig. Join me next time when I add the textured parts of the hull. If you have questions or feedback, feel free to leave a comment. I hope you enjoyed this video and I will see you next time.